What's up, guys? Many NFL legends and current superstars simply didn't live up to the hype in their rookie years. This is no shame. We all know that you have to learn some tough lessons before you can succeed. It's the way of life. Well, at least sometimes it is. We've seen some absolutely incredible and jaw-dropping rookie seasons from some NFL greats. Some were so dominant, in fact, that you'd think they would win the Offensive or Defensive Rookie of the Year award. But over the years, we've seen the wrong guy win the Rookie of the Year, while a more deserving player was totally robbed of the honors. I'm Jason Biondo, and today we present 10 NFL players that were robbed of the Rookie of the Year award. Make sure to subscribe and put on your notifications, because we post videos every single day. Every day's a new video. Subscribe. Do it. Why would you not? You like sports? Then subscribe, because we got them every day. Number 10, Ronnie Lott, 1981. It's not easy putting a defensive player from 1981 on here, since Lawrence Taylor is only one of the greatest defensive players ever. LT won the Defensive Rookie of the Year award after totaling 9.5 sacks, one interception, and one fumble recovery. But it's just that. San Francisco 49ers safety Ronnie Lott had a historic season in his rookie year. In fact, you might call it the greatest season ever for a safety. No joke. Lott finished with 7 interceptions, 2 fumble recoveries, and 3 defensive touchdowns. And to add icing on the cake, Lott was instrumental in helping the 49ers win their first ever Super Bowl championship. This isn't to take anything away from Taylor, but you can easily say Lott's season was just as impressive. 7 picks for a rookie? Unbelievable stuff. That's like crazy. Too bad they weren't able to share the award. Number 9, Keenan Allen, 2013. The San Diego Chargers drafted California wide receiver Keenan Allen with the 76th pick in the 2013 draft. Phillip Rivers was in need of a new big-time playmaker, and Allen was up for the challenge. The 6'2" wide receiver emerged as Rivers' favorite target. He finished with 71 receptions for 1,046 yards and 8 touchdowns. That was enough to help the Chargers go 9-7 and make the playoffs for the first time in 4 years. But Allen's efforts weren't enough, as Green Bay Packers running back Eddie Lacy won Offensive Rookie of the Year instead. Lacy rushed for 1,178 yards and 11 touchdowns, adding 35 catches for 257 yards. Lacy missed just one game, and though he performed well in the backfield, Allen was simply the bigger impact player for his team. Allen had one of the best rookie seasons for a wide receiver, but the voters were all about running backs here. Thus, he missed out on a chance to win the Offensive Rookie of the Year award, and that's such a shame. Number 8, Baker Mayfield, 2018. The 2018 Offensive Rookie of the Year award came down to the top 2 picks. The Cleveland Browns took Oklahoma quarterback Baker Mayfield with the top selection, while the New York Giants settled on Penn State running back Saquon Barkley at number 2. Mayfield didn't play until week 3, replacing an injured Tyrod Taylor. Perhaps that helped Mayfield's chances of winning the award over Barkley, who had one of the most incredible running back seasons ever. Barkley finished his rookie year with 1,307 rushing yards and 11 touchdowns. But he also did plenty of damage as a pass catcher, finishing with 91 receptions for 721 yards and 4 touchdowns. But it's hard to overlook what Mayfield did. He provided plenty of hope for a Browns team that has struggled for 2 decades. He gave them a glimpse of a promising future too. Mayfield's 27 touchdown passes were the most ever for a rookie quarterback. He finished with 3,725 passing yards on the season as well. I mean, the award really could have gone to anybody here, but you easily can make a case that Mayfield was a tad more deserving. With limited talent around him, he pieced together one of the greatest rookie seasons ever, and that was despite not playing in the first 2 games of 2018. Number 7, Patrick Peterson, 2011. Unfortunately for Patrick Peterson, simply not winning the 2011 Defensive Rookie of the Year award means people are going to forget how incredible his first campaign was. That's because Von Miller of the Denver Broncos wound up winning the award instead. No doubt that Miller was deserving of the honors. The number 2 pick from his draft class finished with 11.5 sacks, 3 forced fumbles, and 4 passes defended. But what Peterson, the all-pro cornerback, did was nothing short of amazing. Peterson has 2 interceptions, 2 fumble recoveries, and 13 passes defended. But he also did plenty of damage on special teams. He had a whopping 4 punt return touchdowns, tying a single season record. That included a 99-yard walk-off touchdown against the St. Louis Rams. Peterson was a complete game changer defensively and on special teams. Miller got plenty of damage done as a pass rusher, but it helped that he had Elvis Dumervil on his aside, Peterson was a one-man wrecking machine, and the award undoubtedly belonged to him more than Miller. Number 6, Herschel Walker, 1986. When people think of the name Herschel Walker, they think of one of the most one-sided trades in NFL history. You know, where the Cowboys traded Walker to the Minnesota Vikings, and in return they got a bundle of picks that helped set up the 90s dynasty. But make no mistakes, Walker had one excellent rookie year, and he was more than deserving of the Offensive Rookie of the Year award. The race was pretty much between him and New Orleans Saints running back, Reuben Mays. Now, Mays was the better running back that year, having finished with 1,353 rushing yards and 8 touchdowns. But it's important to note here that Mays had 135 more rushing attempts on the season than Walker. Walker, meanwhile, rushed for 737 yards and 12 touchdowns. When it came to pass catching, Walker easily trumped Mays. He added 76 receptions for 837 yards and 2 touchdowns. Mays, on the other hand, had just 17 catches for 96 yards. So Walker had less rushing yards, but he also had way less carries. He had more all-purpose yards and was simply the bigger impact player. Taking into account their all-around production, Walker probably deserves this award more. Number 5, Marcus Colston, 2006. There were a handful of players that deserve to be on here over Vince Young, the former Tennessee Titans quarterback who won Offensive Rookie of the Year in 2006. Joseph Addai and Santonio Holmes come into mind, for example. But this award should have went to New Orleans Saints wide receiver Marcus Colston, who wasn't selected until the 7th round, 252nd overall. Colston only started 12 games in his rookie year and only took part in 14 contests, and yet he pieced together one of the better rookie wideout seasons in history. Colston finished the year with 70 catches for 1,038 yards and 8 touchdowns. Did we mention he didn't play in 2 games? And yet, Colston was among the top wide receivers that year. He and Drew Brees helped the Saints reach the NFC Championship game. But Young somehow got the award despite barely completing over half his pass attempts. He finished with 12 touchdowns and 13 interceptions, tossing just 2,199 yards. Not very good numbers by any means, but it was enough for Young to win the award over some more deserving guys like Colston. Number 4, LaDainian Tomlinson, 2001. The Chargers legend didn't need much time to make an impact in the NFL. In his rookie year, Tomlinson ran all over defenses and performed like the future MVP candidate and Hall of Famer that we would all know and love. Tomlinson had one of the better rookie seasons in recent memory back in 2001. That year, he rushed for 1,236 yards and 10 touchdowns. Tomlinson also added 59 receptions for 367 yards on the season. But amazingly, that was not even close to being enough for Tomlinson to win the Offensive Rookie of the Year award. Instead, the honor went to Chicago Bears running back Anthony Thomas, who actually posted inferior stats to LT. Thomas had 1,183 rushing yards and 7 touchdowns, while adding 22 receptions for 178 yards. Thomas did average 0.7 more yards per carry, but other than that, Tomlinson was simply the better running back in just about every other statistical category. But yet the 2006 league MVP just didn't do enough to win over voters. Surprising? Not really. Number 3, Ezekiel Elliott, 2016. The Dallas Cowboys came away with a pair of franchise players in the 2016 draft. It started with Ohio State running back Ezekiel Elliott, and then they nabbed Mississippi State quarterback Dak Prescott in the 4th round. Well, little did the Cowboys know that they wound up with the top 2 offensive rookies of 2016. Elliott and Prescott, of course, led Dallas to the top record in the NFC at 13-3, though they fell to the Green Bay Packers in the divisional round of the playoffs. Though Elliott was by far the bigger impact player in Dallas, it was Prescott who won the Offensive Rookie Player of the Year. The first-year quarterback threw for 3,667 yards and 23 touchdowns against just 4 interceptions. But Elliott led the NFL in rushing during his rookie season. He had 1,631 rushing yards and 15 rushing touchdowns, while adding 32 receptions for 363 receiving yards and 1 receiving touchdown. No doubt that Elliott was the machine that kept that Dallas offense going. But as the football world knows, the quarterbacks always seem to have an advantage when it comes to winning awards. Prescott had a great rookie year, but it's not rocket science here. Elliott was by far Dallas's best player in 2016. Number 2, Andrew Luck, 2012. The Indianapolis Colts drafted Andrew Luck with the first overall pick in 2012, while the Washington Redskins settled on Robert Griffin III at number 2. And with that, we were set up for one epic Offensive Rookie of the Year race. Luck and RG3 were tasked with trying to fix a pair of downright terrible teams. teams. And both managed to do just that. Luck led the Colts to an 11-5 record and a playoff berth, a year after they won just two games. Griffin, meanwhile, led the Redskins to a 10-6 record, which was good enough to win the NFC East crown. But there was never really any doubt that Luck was the better rookie here. Though RG3 had a better completion percentage and fewer picks, Luck had 23 touchdowns. Griffin had 20. Luck had 4,374 passing yards. RG3 had 3,200. And who wound up winning the Offensive Rookie of the Year award? Griffin. I mean, sure, he dazzled with his strong two-way play and all, but Luck was easily the better and more dominant of the two. Just saying. Number 1, Reggie White, 1985. The Philadelphia Eagles and Green Bay Packers legend is widely regarded as one of the top 5 all-time greatest defensive players. Reggie White won Super Bowl 31 with Green Bay and was a 2-time Defensive Player of the Year, racking up the Pro Bowl and First Team All-Pro selections. White also had one of the most incredible rookie seasons you'll ever see, and yet it wasn't enough to win Defensive Rookie of the Year. White finished with 13 sacks in 13 games, to go along with 100 combined tackles as well. But the award went to Indianapolis Colts linebacker Dwayne Bickett, who finished with 6 sacks. White missed 3 games and finished with 7 more sacks, but it wasn't enough to win the award. He was at least named NFC Defensive Rookie of the Year, but there's no way Bickett was better than him in 1995. That award should have gone to White, without question. Which other NFL players got robbed of the Rookie of the Year award? Join us in the comment section below. Make sure to follow myself and Total Pro Sports on social media. We post great content all the time. You guys gotta go check us out. Go check out our profiles, give it a look, give us some likes, give us some love, because we love you too. And like, why not? Go follow us, please. If you like this video, give it a like. It takes one click right down there. One click. That's all you gotta do. If this is your first time coming around TPS, make sure to subscribe, because every single day is a new video. We had a new video yesterday. We have a new video today. Then tomorrow, new video. 10 days down the line, 2 years down the line, a new video. Subscribe. Of course, thank you so much for watching. I'm Jason Biondo, and I'll see you next time. My knee.